So if you have gone through the previous classes of instruction set and other things, so today's class about our simple programming of 8051 and something regarding jumps. Okay, in previous class we have seen branch control instructions, in that we have seen call instruction, jump instruction, the difference between call and jump. Okay, but in jump we have three different types of jumps. Okay, so what are those jumps and when they are used, we will see in our present class. Okay, so shall I start the class? Someone please message yes. See, so in our today's class, I will explain you in detail about jump instructions. So what are the jumps available and how to use all those jumps. Okay. So I will start with last slide. Okay. So this is nothing but the summary of all the jumps. So what are the jumps available? First thing, so you have long jump, short jump, and absolute jump. Three types of jumps are available. How they are different from each other? So I have again some features here. Coming to range, okay, so this long jump, its range is up to 64 kb. okay, and if you consider S jump, it is in backward direction -128 bytes, and in forward direction from that current position it will jump up to 127 bytes. Okay, coming to A jump, it can jump anywhere from 2 kb, anywhere up to 2 kb, but there is a condition that it should be within the same page. So I will explain what is this page and all those things, but you see these things. Okay, if you remember these things, I can explain individually these things very easily. So coming to this size of the instruction, so before this size of the instruction, you see the syntax. Syntax is what? L jump, L ADD. Okay, long jump, long address. What is L ADD? This long address. Okay, and here you can see here long address means it is of 16 byte, consider 2050. So L jump will occupy 1 byte, 20 will occupy 1 byte, 50 will occupy 1 byte. So because of that, its instruction length is what? 3 bytes. Okay, coming to S jump, S jump R ADD. So R is standing here for relative address. So here is S jump will occupy 1 byte, and this R add is of 8 bits or 1 byte. So combinedly it will be occupying only 2 bytes. Similarly, absolute jump. Okay, syntax is A jump S add. S here it is indicating short address. Okay, once again it will be of 8 bits or 1 byte. So 1 byte for A jump, 1 byte for address, combined it will be giving 2 bytes. Okay, so what is new address? Okay, so what is happening with this new address and what are the advantages and disadvantages, I will discuss individually. Okay, okay, you can see here, simply you see what is advantage. So it can access up to one complete 64 kb, that is complete full memory. What we have maximum memory in our 8051, accessible memory is up to 64 kb. That means you are accessing full memory with the help of L jump. Coming to S jump, so all the conditional jumps. Okay, what are the conditional jumps? We have seen in yesterday's class or in the previous class, compare and jump if not equal, jump if carry, jump if not carry, okay, jump if bit, jump if not bit, all these things. All these things come under S jump, so that is the advantage. Okay, why we are preferring S jump and all those things, I will explain. Once again, here range is higher than, okay, in A jump, what is the range? Up to 2 kb. So that is definitely greater than this 256. That is definitely greater than 256, and byte size is also 2 bytes. So individually they have disadvantages. What are the disadvantages? So it is of 3 byte instruction. 3 byte means, so that is available in outside of our microcontroller from ROM. So you need to fetch that instruction. To fetch that one instruction or 1 byte, you require one fetch cycle, one read cycle. So to fetch 3 bytes from external memory, you need 3 cycles. Okay, so that because you are every time you are fetching 3 cycles, it becomes slow. Here 2 bytes means it is easy to fetch 2 bytes from external memory rather than fetching 3 bytes. So it becomes easy, but disadvantages is what? It has short range. Coming to third one, it occupies 8 different opcodes. Okay, so I will explain these things in detail. Okay, I hope this thing is very, very clear. Simply, in this slide, I have mentioned what is the range. Okay, ranges are available. What is the syntax? Okay, what is the size of the instruction? And what happens to the new address? That means PC will occupy which address? Okay, I will explain that part also. And what is the advantage of this LJMP, SJMP, and AJMP, and drawbacks of all these three things? Okay. Okay, let us start with LJMP. Okay, LJMP here. Okay, it is the most simplest one because simply you are giving the address here. Directly you can provide the address here. So in general, what is the syntax saying? Syntax is what? LJMP comma L address. L address is what? Long address. So these things are available in your program memory. The code which is available, where it will be stored, it will be available in program memory or ROM, that is of 64 KB. So when I say 64 KB, what will be the addresses? Where it will start from? It will start from all the way from all four zeros to all four Fs. Okay. Suppose I have started this thing. Okay. I have come up to PC 1000. So here an instruction is available. LJMP 5000. So what is your 5000? This is your long address. So what will happen? Immediately what will happen? So you will end up this normal execution or sequential execution and you will jump to this specified address. How you will jump, sir? To jump, what should happen? PC should hold the address of next instruction. So this address 5000 will be given to PC. Okay, it will hold the address of next instruction. Means if we want to jump to this address, PC will be given this particular address and you will jump to this 5000 and you will continue the execution from here. Okay, you consider only this part. Okay, I will take a practical example. So why this L add is called long jump? Okay, what is the advantage of this long jump? Means it can jump anywhere from 00. If you have written the same instruction LJMP 5000 at 00, even it could jump up to this. If you have written at 00 LJMP comma F, all FFs, 4 Fs, even then it could have jumped to this particular location. That means it can jump anywhere from all 4 zeros to all 4 Fs. That range is its range is what? Complete full memory, that is 64 KB. Now I will take a practical example. Okay, consider example of our RUKT. RUKT is your complete memory, 64 KB. Okay, now if our class is what? AB2 112 or 113. Consider example 112. Okay, you are in 112. So if you want a student, if I want to say a student, you go to SAC building in Kabadikon, there a particular student is available, go there. So how I will inform him? Okay, I should inform complete address. Okay, from AB2, I can't say you go in this right direction or left direction or something. I can't give in that particular manner. So how to inform the address? Okay, complete address. So I will inform him, go to SAC building. Okay, that will be behind PUC buildings. Okay, in the SAC building, there you will be having a Kabaddi code. There you can go. Okay, I will mention complete address. So the length of my address is, it will be long. So because of that reason, I am mentioning what? It has long address. Okay, so I can inform, I can send that particular student anywhere in our complete campus. I can send him to our department building, electrical building or electronics building. I can send him to hospital. Simply I need to mention complete address. Okay, if I am sending him to our department building, what I will mention? You go to triple department building, in that go to this particular power electronics lab. So I need to mention complete address. So that complete address becomes long. So because of that reason, this address is called long address. Okay, you are using what? How many bytes here? 50 will occupy 1 byte, 00 will occupy 1 byte. That means totally it will occupy 2 bytes. Okay, and LJMP will occupy 1 byte. Totally it will be having what? 3 bytes of instruction. So that is regarding a long jump. Okay, I have taken some examples, but don't consider those things. Consider the example of our RUKT, because you are familiar with your RUKT and you can easily understand what I'm saying regarding RUKT. Okay, so if you are mentioning the address of SAC building, in that particularly mentioning Kabaddi code, so it becomes long address. Okay, so then you need to mention complete address, SAC building, particular room, So a particular code, okay, particular area. So it becomes long address. Okay. Now coming to next thing. But in practice, okay, I will say what is the disadvantage here. Okay, before going to short jump, I will mention the disadvantage with our long jump. See, if I want, this instruction is available in ROM. Okay, microcontroller is available, but this external ROM is this ROM is what, external to our access, our access. So we need to bring that instruction from external ROM. So for that you need one fetch cycle. Okay, fetching the opcode and getting the address. So that is what fetch cycle. So to get that, first you need to get this opcode ljump. So it requires one fetch cycle. 50 is available in 1 byte. It is of 1 byte. So I require one cycle. 00 is available as 1 byte. So I require one cycle. So completely I require how many cycles? I require 3 cycles. Okay. So I'm where we are using this jump. We have seen what DJNZ, decrement and jump if not zero, R7 comma back. What is the meaning, Suresh? If you are gone through the previous class, in the previous class I have taken a program. There I have written what DJNZ R7 comma back. That means decrement and jump, and compare with R7. If it is zero, if the R7 is zero, then you need to jump to next instruction. If it is not zero, then you need to jump to label back. That means you are performing loop operations. Yesterday we have seen what, in the previous class we have seen what, infinite loop and finite loop. So there in finite loop we are using DJNZ. So that means I am going to access that specified part of the program, that loop, many number of times. Suppose coming to practical example, if I want to send a song to you people, so that generally today's high clarity songs, high definition songs are of 5 MB, consider 5 MB. So I won't transfer 5 MB, means 5 million instructions. So I will transfer only one instruction. I will write a program to transfer only one instruction, and I will loop, and I will select a particular memory location, and I will loop that thing, increment that location, send, increment location and send. So I will loop that particular part. That means for looping I am using DJNZ. Okay, so how many times this ljump will be used in that, in place of DJNZ? So it will be used 5 million times. Okay, if your loop is performed for 5 million times, 5 megabyte song means 5 million times. So 5 million times you are using what, 5 MB. Okay, 5 million times you are using this ljump 5000. That means each time you require 3 cycles to get this instruction. That means 5 million into 3, that many number of cycles, 15 million cycles are required to get this instruction every time. So this is a disadvantage. So our transferring of the data becomes slow. So for that reason we are shifting to next jump. Why, sir? In short jump, okay, coming to this short jump, you have RAD. So this RAD is of what, only 8 bits or, okay, this RAD is of 8 bit or 1 byte. The combined instruction will be of only 2 bytes. That means you require one less cycle. That means for every time you require one less cycle, that means to transfer 5 million bytes of data, a song of 5 million byte of 5 MB, now you require, there you require how many, 15 million cycles, fetch cycles, but here you require one less, that means only 10 million. So in that fashion you are decreasing 5 million cycles of fetch. So for that reason we will prefer sjump. Okay, so what is the syntax here? Sjump RADD. So R is specifying what, relative address. We have seen what is its range. You can jump from current location to 127 in forward direction and -128 in backward direction. Okay, consider this thing. So up to 127 in forward direction downwards, and backwards up to -128, you can get the answer. Up to that you can jump in forward and backward direction. Okay, so because you are reducing one fetch cycle every time in a loop, if you are performing loop 5 million times, you are reducing 5 million fetch cycles. For that reason we are preferring short jump. Okay, now consider the practical example. Once again, consider RJKT. Suppose we are in our class 112. Okay, 112. If I want a student to go to 105 class and get marker from that particular student, so what I will inform, how I will inform? So this is our class. Okay, you come out of our class, move right and take after 5 classes you will enter into 105, get the student. So I am explaining the student address of 105 with respect to our class. So that becomes what? We are in a particular class. Okay, so our address becomes base address and he is moving, okay, 5 classes ahead. So that is, that address becomes what? Relative address. Okay, so I am explaining once again. Suppose we are in our class 112. So if I want a student to go to 105 class and get marker from that class, so how I will explain? You come out of the class, move in right direction. After crossing 5 classes, you will get into 105, get a marker from that particular student. So that is what I am explaining, the address with respect to our class. Our class is base address and he is moving forward direction 5 classes, that becomes relative address. Okay, so because of that reason, our add is what? Relative address. So if I want to jump to 1008, okay, sjump, because its range is short, suppose I want to jump to 1008. So what I will mention, sir, sjump r add, okay, sjump r add, in place of r add what I will mention? 08. Okay, so this is what? Relative address, 1000 plus 08, that becomes 08, becomes relative address. Okay, 1000 plus 08, so our 1008 becomes base address and this 08 becomes relative address. Combined it will jump to 1008, but in practice it won't take 08. We should write 06. Why, sir? See, this 1000, at this 1000 you are having sjump comma r add. R add is of 1 byte, sjump is of 1 byte. That means in this location, one location can handle only 8 bits. That means at the location 1000 you are having sjump. At 1001 you are having what? R add. So when I am accessing R add, what will happen? PC becomes incremented. That means it is pointing to 1002. Okay, please understand this. It is very, very simple. Okay, 1000, at this location sjump is available, which is 1 byte. Okay, where this R add will be available? In next memory location. What is the address of next memory location? 1001. So when I am reading this 1001, what will happen? PC will be incremented automatically. So now PC is pointing to 1002. So you are at 1002, then what should be the distance? It should be only 6. 1002 plus 6 becomes 1008. Okay, so for this thing you need to understand why we are using sjump, why we are using relative address, because we are giving the address from our reference. Our address will be taken as reference. Okay, see why. You see here I have explained in the previous slide what I have explained. So our sjump will be available in 1000 location and r add will be available in 1001 location. Okay, so when I am reading this r add, PC will be incremented automatically. That means it is pointing to 1002. And how much distance you need to travel now? Only 6 locations. So what will be your r add? It should be definitely 06. Okay, I think this is very clear. Okay, now coming to a jump. Why we are going for a jump, sir? Okay, because we had some drawback with L jump. That is, it is consuming more memory, 3 bytes of memory, and it is increasing the time to fetch. That is 3 read cycles are required. So it is decreasing the speed. So for that reason, we have shifted to S jump. But the advantage is that all the conditional jumps are S jump. Okay, but the disadvantage is that the range is very short. Okay, so considering this disadvantage, I will be shifting to a jump now. Now compare a jump. Once again, I will take the practical example here. Once again, our RGKT. But see here, when I am saying the address as a reference to our class 112, I can say come out of the class, right, move in right hand direction. For 5 classes, you will get 105. Or if I want to give the address of 113, okay, or 101. So I will say you go in the left hand direction, after 3 classes you will get 101. So using this relative address concept, I can address only in that particular floor. So my range of addressing using this relative address concept is very less. Okay, similarly sjump is having what? A very short range. So because it is using relative address, to avoid that thing, to overcome that, we have come with a new idea. That is what? A jump, absolute jump. So what is the range, sir? The range is that it can jump anywhere up to 2 kilobytes. okay, but there is a condition, I will explain that. And what is the advantage, second advantage of AJMP? It is also occupying only 2 bytes of instructions, 2 bytes of memory. AJMP will occupy 1 byte, and the S address is what? Short address. That S address will also occupy 1 byte. That means you are having 2 byte instruction and the range is large. So this is an advantage, okay, that is very good. Okay, so because of that reason we are going with this, but finally we won't prefer this. I will explain the disadvantage of this thing later. But what is happening here, see, you have started with 1000, okay, your program started here, you have continued up to 1234. Now you need to jump to 1579. So if you see the difference, 1579 minus 1234, it is greater than 256. So definitely you can't jump using sjump, because its range is only up to 256. So you can't jump with this thing. Okay, now can you use ljump? Yes, definitely you can use, but you will decrease your speed because it is a 3 byte instruction. Okay, for that I am not preferring. So best suitable is what? Ajump. See, but what I am writing here, ajump 79, I want to jump to 1579, but I am mentioning only 79. Why? Because S address, short address, it is of only 1 byte. So definitely I need to go with this only 1 byte, 79. Okay, I will take an example here, sir, practical example. We are in our class AB2112. Okay, AB2112. Now our whole campus is of, consider our whole campus is of 64 KB. Okay, each building, so I am dividing our whole campus into 32 slots, 32 buildings. Consider our AB2 is a building, okay, each building is having a capacity of 2 KB. Please listen here, consider the example. Our whole campus is of 64 KB. okay, I am dividing it into 32 locations, 32 buildings. Each building will be having definitely what capacity, sir? 64 divided by 32, definitely will get 2 KB. So each building capacity is what? 2 KB. okay, now if I am in 112, okay, if we are taking class in 112, I want to send a student to 312. So how I can inform? I can't use the relative address because its range is very short. But can I use long address? I can use long address to address any address in our campus, but it consumes more memory and its delay time is more. So for that reason I won't prefer that. So what is the alternate available to me? I will use AJMP. I will inform, okay, you move to, we are in 112, you move 2 floors, okay, up, okay, you go upstairs 2 floors, then you will find 312 exact in our location, exactly above us 2 floors, definitely you will find 312 class. In that fashion I will inform the student. So am I informing him go to AB2, okay, AB2 third floor 312 class? No, I am not mentioning in that fashion. Simply I am informing, I am keeping aside AB2 as common, because we are in AB2, AB2 remains constant. So I won't mention him about AB2. So, but there is a problem, sir. Simply I am mentioning here, I am mentioning only 12. You go to 12, because why I am mentioning here 12? I am informing the student, go to, actually I want to inform him to go to 312 class, but using this absolute jump, because there is a restriction of address, it can handle only 1 byte, that means 2 numbers. So because of that restriction I am informing you go to, actually I want to inform him go to third floor 312, but I can't use that because of restriction of our byte size. So I am simply informing go to 12. Okay, we are in AB2 because definitely it will select AB2, that is default. But there is a problem with this thing that comes as a disadvantage. Okay, so how many 12 classes are available, sir, in our AB2? Ground floor 012 class is available. Okay, first floor 112 class is available, second floor 212 class is available, third floor 312 class is available. Consider our building is of 8 floors, so 8 different locations will be available. 0, okay, 8 floors means 012 112 212 312 412 512 612 612 712. So 8 different locations are available. Now the processor has to understand, you need to send that student in which particular location. So that is derived from, okay, you can see here, see this part. So our PC is having these 5 bits. That is what our AB2, it is remaining constant. And this 1-2, 8 bits of 1-2, it will also remain constant. What you need to change, sir? You need to mention in front of 1-2, you need to mention 0-1-2, or you need to mention 1 as 1-1-2, you need to mention 2 for 2-1-2, you need to mention 3 to specify 3-1-2, 4-1-2. So, but this 3 locations means 2 power 3 is what? 2 power 3 is 8. So, 8 different locations with that name 1-2 are available. Okay. So, for this, because of this reason, this symbol A jump 79, it will be having what? 8 different opcodes. So one instruction is having 8 different opcodes. See, for our example, we are in 112. So for this one, we are not mentioning our classes 112. Simply I am mentioning 12. So there are 012, 112, 212, 312, up to 712. So 8 different opcodes will be generated for this 12. So because of that reason, we are not preferring A jump. So when you require, when there is no alternate for you, then only you will go with this A jump. Okay. Why? The reason is that simply you are mentioning only 1-2 here. So there are possible 8 cases. So for to deal with that 8 cases, you will need 8 different opcodes. For that reason, I am not preferring A jump. I think this is very clear. Okay. Simply, if you don't want to go in detail with all those jumps, simply you understand this thing, that is more than enough. Okay. L jump, what is the range? It is up to 64 kb, that is whole campus you can access this L jump. S jump, it is up to positive direction 127, negative direction 128. That means from our reference class we can go to some 10 classes in forward direction and classes backward direction. Okay. Considering A jump, so I have mentioned what, using A jump I can jump up to 2 kb. So our building is of 2 kb. I can jump from anywhere up to from ground floor to third floor. Any class I can jump using this what? A jump. Okay. But the restriction is that you should be in the same building. From AB2 112, you can't jump to AB1 103. So that is not possible with A jump. That is possible with L jump. Okay. So for that reason, there is a restriction that within the same size, same page, within the same building, consider AB2 as building. Size of instruction is here, ljump is having 3 bytes because of syntax ljump L address. This L address is of 2 bytes. Okay, here size of instruction of sjump is 2 bytes because sjump relative address is of only 1 byte. Similarly, ajump is having 2 bytes because ajump is opcode is having 1 byte. Short address, once again it is of 1 byte. What are the new addresses here? PC will get the new address as 16 bit. We have taken the example of 1500. Okay, this 1500 will be loaded in PC. Now here we have taken PC plus relative address. We have taken the example what? 1008. 1000 plus this relative address becomes 06. Why? Because I have explained in a clear manner, because our sjump will occupy 1 byte, rad will occupy 1 byte. Up to that time PC will be having 102. So to get to 108, we need to add only 6 here. Okay, now coming to third one, PC. We will mention only 8 bit address, but which address? I am taking the example of 112. So in that 112, I am mentioning only 12. So which 12? It may be 112, it may be 212, it may be 312. So that you need to decode with the help of your opcode. So for decoding that, you have different 8 opcodes. So that becomes a tedious job. So for that, we are not preferring A jump. So because here the delay is more, okay, the delay is more here. So every time you need 3 fetch cycles, okay, memory consumption is more. So the best one what we are using is what? Sjump. Okay, so because of all that reasons, all the jumps, conditional jump, jump if carry, jump if no carry, jump if bit set, jump if not bit set, jump if bit set and carry and clear. See, JBC clear. Yesterday a student has asked, can you explain JBC? What is JBC here? Jump if bit is set, and while jumping you clear that particular bit. CJN is what? Compare and jump if not equal, DJNZ, decrement and jump if not 0, JZ is for what? Jump if 0, JNZ is for jump if no 0. That means here we are not accessing 0 flag, simply we are accessing what? Accumulator. these are the jumps and they all come under S jump. And drawbacks, we have seen instruction length and byte, it is consuming more bytes. What is the disadvantage of S jump? Short range. Disadvantage here is what? For one instruction you are generating 8 different opcodes. Okay, so with this jumps, the topic related to all the jumps is completed. So I will move into next topic, that is what? Simple programs. I think this, up to this, it is very very clear. If you have any doubts in this session, you can ask. Okay, if you have any doubts, you can message right now. If you are clear with this thing, you can simply message, continue with next topic. Someone can mention that. Continue. Okay, so please do one thing. I will send notes of this particular class, but you please do one thing. Okay, I have mentioned some other examples there. I got some other idea. Okay, I have taken some other reference and taken some example, some examples, different examples what I have explained here. So you please copy. Okay, you write the examples considering SJMP. Okay, SJMP means our class 112 and we are moving to 105. So this comes as relative address. Okay, for long jump, whole memory can be accessible, that is our campus. Consider this example, you can understand better. Okay, I will moving to second topic. Okay, coming to simple programs of 8051. So in the previous classes we have seen how to add two numbers. Okay, we have taken the example of add two numbers available 20H and 21H and store them in 22. Okay, and we have seen some other programs as using direct addressing mode and indirect addressing mode. What we have seen, block transfer program, that is some 5 bytes are available starting from 20H location and you need to transfer that data into a memory location starting from 30H. So we have seen using direct and indirect addressing. Okay, now I will start this thing. Consider the example. So this example is very easy. Multiply two numbers which are available in 20H location and 21H location and store the result in 22 and 23. So why I am mentioning two things are 22 and 23? So before going to that, you see this thing. So what is your MUL operation? I will read the question once. Multiply two numbers which are stored in 20H location and 21H location and store the result in 22H and 23H. Okay, why we need this 23H? Okay, if you are aware of this MUL instruction, we have seen all these instructions. MUL AB, see here, MUL AB, the syntax is not MUL A comma B. Okay, it will be giving you errors. So it will be simply what? MUL AB. So what will happen, sir? A and B will be multiplied and the result will be stored in A. Okay, that is what, lower byte, and the extra component, if it is generated, you will get the higher byte, that will be stored in B. Suppose you are multiplying 02 with 04, you will get 8, that can be easily stored in A. Okay, suppose you are multiplying FF with FF, you will get 1FE as answer. So 1F will FE will be stored in A and that one will be stored in B. Okay, consider any example. Okay, you need to understand that your result is stored in accumulator as well as in B. So because of that reason, what I have mentioned in the question, store the result in 22H and in 23H. So you will be storing 22 in A and 23 in B in 23. Why, sir? Lower byte will move in lower address and higher byte will move in higher address. So we have seen already this thing, Little Indian model. So lower, the person with small height will occupy small lower byte and the person with higher height will occupy upper byte. So that is what Little Indian model. Considering that thing, I am mentioning what? 22, okay, lower byte is what? A. It will be stored in 22 hex location, lower location, and higher byte is what? B. That will be stored in location 23. Okay. So our program is very simple to understand in better manner, because I am little worried that I have taken this thing. In general, this is not necessary. In class, I won't take these things. But as you people are not available in front of me, so to make this programming easy, I have taken this. Directly, you can understand here, but I have taken here to understand more complex programs also in this fashion. So see here, what is mentioned, 20H is available, carrying some content. 21H is also carrying some content. So first thing what I need to do, if I want to multiply these things, I will take the content available 20H into A with some instruction. And second thing what I need to do, directly I will multiply A with B. Okay, I will take content in B, 21, the content available in 21 is moved into B. Okay, two steps are done. Third step is what we need to multiply, which is mentioned as number 3. You will get the result as higher byte is stored in B, lower byte is stored in A. So what I will do now, the result should be transferred. So I will take the lower byte and I will transfer into 22H. Take the higher byte and will transfer into 23H, which is nothing but Little Indian model. Okay, very easy. Now directly I am writing the program. Move A comma 20H. What is happening, sir? The content available 20H will be moved into A. Similarly, move B comma 21H. Content available 21 will be moved into B. Now AB is having the contents. Directly write mul AB. What is happening? The result A and B are multiplied. Result is stored in A and B. Now you need to transfer lower byte into 22H. That is what? Content available in A is moved to 22H location. Move 23 comma B. So what is happening, sir? The content available in B is moved to 23H. Okay. And final thing. This you have come to learn about this thing. So I am writing one here as label and S jump here. So what will happen, sir, here? So S jump here means it will jump to this location here. Once again it will come, it will jump to this location. So what you have generated here, sir, you have generated an infinite loop. Okay, so why this S jump here instruction is used? It is quite similar to our return instruction, informing that you return, you hand over the control of execution to our disk operating system and return to main program. Okay, you can write return, even if you are writing here RET, that is okay, but in we prefer this one. Okay, you can write end. And what is end, sir? End is your assembler directive. The assembler directive will inform you hand over the control of execution to our disk operating system and move to main program. So that even that is acceptable, but I want you to learn this thing. So I have written this thing here, S jump here. What is happening, sir? It will jump to label here, it will come here. Once again it will execute, so it is entering into infinite loop. So what is happening in this thing? So if I am, so it will be in infinite loop. So will it go continuously up to infinite time? No. So after some time the processor will realize that I am performing no operation, nothing is done here. So after that it will enter into power saving mode and then it will come out of this program. So to explain this, okay, to explain this, I will take the example, live example, take the example of my mobile. So you can see here. So what is a program? Programming, so combination of programs is nothing but a software or an application. So what we see, you can see my mobile phone here. So all these, okay, you can see here. So all these icons, what you can see, they are what? Applications. Okay. If I'm accessing a program, means if these applications are nothing but internally, they are all programs. So suppose I have opened this notes. Okay. I'm working with this thing. Okay. I'm working with this. So I am accessing the programs from raw. Completion, what I will do? Simply I will come out of this, okay, by pressing back button. Okay, you can take your own mobile and you can do. So here back button is available. Okay, simply I have pressed back. So this is not similar to S jump here. I have mentioned S jump here, but have I closed this? Have I hand over the control to disk operating system and come out of the loop? No. So still it is continuing with this loop. So what will happen if you hold this for 10 minutes? What will happen? Automatically it will be what it will become. Okay, it will start saving the power. Okay, so automatically it will do. So purposefully I have pressed this power button. Okay, to avoid delay. Okay, it will go into power saving mode first. Then it will realize that it is performing no operation. Okay, after coming out of that application, it is performing nothing. So automatically it will come out of that program. First, what it will do? Sjump here means it will jump to that location. Continuously it will be performing what? Infinite loop. After some time, it will realize that it is performing nothing. Okay, it is performing nothing. So what it should do? Immediately what it will do? It will come out of that program. Okay, it will enter into power saving mode. So the screen has become black. So power saving mode is on. So after some time, once again it will see nothing is happening. It will come out of that program automatically. It will happen. Okay, to explain this, I have taken the example.